U.S. President Joe Biden criticizes Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu for making a mistake in Gaza. Biden expressed concern over Netanyahu's actions, particularly regarding strikes on aid personnel in the enclave. The American president also expressed his desire for Israel to propose a ceasefire. Over 33,000 Palestinians have been killed in the six-month war, while many of Gaza's 2.3 million people are at risk of famine.
I think what he's doing is a mistake. I don't agree with his approach. So what I'm calling for the Israelis to just call for a ceasefire, allow for the next 6-8 weeks total access to all food and medicine going into the country. I've spoken with everyone from the Saudis to the Jordanians, to the Egyptians. They're prepared to move in. They're prepared to move this food in. And I think there's no excuse to not provide for the medical and the food needs of those people. They should be done now.
The British government rejecting pressure to suspend weapons exports to Israel over charges of humanitarian violations in Gaza. That statement coming from British Foreign Secretary David Cameron in a joint news conference with U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken. Cameron says this is based on their latest assessment of the situation in Gaza, though he admits that concerns remain.
The latest assessment leaves our position on export licenses unchanged. This is consistent with the advice that I and other ministers have received, and as ever, we will keep the position under review. Let me be clear, though, we continue to have grave concerns around the humanitarian access issue in Gaza, both for the period that was assessed and subsequently.
The U.S., which is by far the largest provider of weapons to Israel, has also rejected calls to suspend weapons shipments, despite rising frustration with Prime Minister Netanyahu's conduct of the war. Another setback for reproductive rights in the United States, Arizona's top court revives a law dating back to 1864, which bans abortion. The state's Supreme Court ruled 4-2 to reinstate the 19th century law, which makes abortion punishable by 2 to 5 years in prison, except when the mother's life is at risk. In response, Arizona's Attorney General Chris Mace had said she is exploring the possibility of appealing the decision to the Supreme Court. While Mace has vowed to or not to enforce the law, local prosecutors could. State Governor Katie Hobbs also slamming the court's decision.
Arizona's 2022 abortion ban is extreme and hurts women. And the near total Civil War era ban that continues to hang over our heads only serves to create more chaos for women and doctors in our state. As governor, I promised I would do everything in my power to protect our reproductive freedoms.
A Filipino woman killed while her husband is in critical condition after a fire hit a residential building in Sharjah, United Arab Emirates, last week. The Migrant Workers Department says 11 other Filipinos were evacuated from the same building. Aside from the Filipino casualty, 4 others were killed while 44 more were injured in the fire. The DMW says it is working to address the needs of the affected Filipinos as well as the repatriation of the victims' remains.
UAE authorities, no, yung mga investigative fire authorities natin, and di magtatagal ay makauwi na siya. Pero yun nga, we will have to await the low signal of the UAE authorities, and of course we're coordinating with our embassy and our consulate general's office, the DFA. In due time, of course, we will provide the necessary financial assistance to them. And kasabay nito, kung may legal implications yung pangyayari, we will also engage yung ating legal retainer, retained lawyer, para suriin ang sitwasyon. At kung meron mang legal liabilities, of course, we are also relying on the UAE authorities, no, yung mga investigative fire authorities.